Now we're going to talk about 10 electrical measuring devices. These are the things that we will learn in this lecture. First, the principle of electromagnetic and electrostatic deflection. Okay. Then we have thermal heating, and we have ammeters, voltmeters, ohmmeters, and we have multimeters. We also have FET voltmeters. And then we need to learn about watt meter and also watt hour meters. So this is very pretty common to most of the residential houses. We have digital read out meters. And then there are other types of meters such as frequency counters. Okay, so let's start with the first one, electromagnetic and electrostatic deflection. So first we talk about electromagnetic. So if you can recall, electromagnetic is when the moving charges, moving charges, or we call this one current, okay? So because of the presence of the current, then we have deflection. Now electrostatic is stationary charges, okay? Stationary charges, okay? When two body of with charges, different amount of charges, then there between them there's a electric field, okay? So then there, it also creates a deflection. So now we talk about first the moving charges, okay? So if you notice, if you look at the simple galvanometer on your left, so you can see the deflection, no, due to the presence of the current, no? So the moment this turns on, okay, so then there's a current flowing, and then the deflection will change, no, according to the magnitude of the current. So this is the circuit for that illustration. So this one is a drawing, it's a representation, and then this is the circuit, okay, also a representation of the drawing, no? It demonstrates galvanometer indicates relative current, okay? Relative current. So resistances are in ohms. K indicates kilo ohms. So we have 230 ohms. So this is most of the time fixed. And then we have a potentiometer. We'll talk about it later. And then we have a voltage, okay? So then we have a galvanometer. So depending on the amount of resistance here, okay, by potentiometer you can vary the amount of the resistance. It can be from 0 to 10k. Most of the time, if you have a 10k potentiometer, so it can be adjusted from 0 to 10k. Okay, so by changing the resistance, the current also changes, and then this relative current also changes the deflection. Okay, and so that's the idea. We will talk about some examples later in the voltmeter and ammeter. Okay, so this is the principle of galvanometer and ammeter. Now for electrostatic, which is the principle used for voltmeter. Okay, so we'll talk about it also later. So, but the idea is you have two, you have an electrode, okay, and then you have two bodies here, no? Depending on the amount of charges, for example, Q1. Body Q1 and then body Q2. So depending on the difference of their charges, this moves, no, either towards each other or away from each other. Okay, so depending on the so it either foiled or it will against, no, or repel or attract, depending on the amount of charges. Okay, so this is electrostatic in the sense that the charges present in this Q2 and then Q1, okay, if there's no difference, then there will be no attraction or repulsion. Okay, so this is the principle of electrostatics. So the amount of charges present in this body and also this body depend creates a movement for these two foils. Okay, then let's proceed to thermal heating. So this is what we so-called the thermocouple principle. So with a hot wire meter, we can use a thermometer to measure the extent of the heating. Okay, so you'll notice there's a thermometer here. Then you have a voltmeter, and then we have the ammeter, okay? If you notice, this is the heating resistor, okay? Now, in the materials, some of the metals or materials, if they are, if the temperature increases, the resistance also decreases, okay? So in that sense, because they are the temperature and the resistance are actually inversely proportional, no? So therefore, by changing the temperature, okay, so you have a different resistance, and because of the changing resistance, the voltage and the current also changes. If you have a constant source, then you have a changing current, okay? Changing current in that sense. So this is the most common principle for sensors. So previously we have voltmeter and galvanometer. Now in this principle, this is often used in sensors. Now thermocouple principle works in reverse as well. So when we apply heat to a thermocouple, it generates DC, which we can measure with a galvanometer. Okay, so yeah, it's a wide. There are many applications on thermocouple principle. So ammeters. So a magnetic compass surrounded by a coil of wire makes an effective but temperamental current measuring meter. Okay, so this is the a principle of electromagnetics in the first topic. Okay, so this is the principle. So when you have current flowing, okay, so it will be measured by the meter. Now take note, okay, so this is the current flowing here. Okay, now of course it will turn around here, the current, and it creates an electromagnetic field, and that what makes it, because of the electromagnetic field, no, of this current, okay, so, and then with the presence of magnet, two magnets, okay, in the left and the right, left and right, so how you call it, the compass will move accordingly, okay, based on the magnitude of the magnetic field, okay, so it will move. So the magnitude, if the magnitude of current is lower, then it will this compass tends to go this way, okay, or placed in this section or area, and if it is stronger, then it will go on the other side, okay, because it is more attracted to the north pole. Or north pole of the magnet, the other side, and repelled by the south pole. Okay, so and take note of this compass must lie flat on a horizontal surface. Okay, that's why our meter is oftentimes, especially for analog. Okay, this is for analog devices. Okay, we'll talk about it later. Now, ammeter should be connected in series. If this is your current. Okay, so this is the two, actually this is the ammeter, okay, this is the ammeter, so you connect it to the other side. Okay, if you want to know the this is the current flowing, if you want to know the how much current, so the meter, okay, so this is your, should be connected in series, otherwise if you put it in parallel, your device might get broken, okay? So we'll talk about it also later. Now, when and how it will be disastrous when we talk about circuits, okay? So it's like connecting two bridges, no? Oh, sorry, connecting two roads that are separated. Okay, so voltmeters. So the same principle. Sorry, this is for the electrostatic deflection. So if you notice, you have here a plate and then another plate, so basically they have different amount of charges, Q1 and Q2. Okay, now depending on your measure, for example this is your circuit inside, and then you want to measure the voltage at this certain nodes, no, so for example you have a circuit here, no, so etc. Okay, you want to measure the voltage at that point, so that is here, no. So you connect, so if they have difference in charges, okay, then this will deflect, okay, this will deflect, especially if the magnitude is greater, then it tends to be on the right side. Okay, why? Why it tends to be in the right side? Because this will be more attracted to this one. So the amount of attraction, if it is very strong, then this compass will turn on the right. Okay, now if it is not so strong by the gravity, you know, so the gravity is stronger than the attraction between them, so it tends to be towards the other side. Okay, so the compass. Okay, so I think you understand. So voltage, okay, we talked about it in the previous class. So it's called electromotive force or potential difference, because the potential difference between the two nodes, okay, or the difference between the charges. But we're not measuring charges here. We are measuring the voltage, okay, the electromotive force, the force of attraction between the two plates. Okay, so we can also talk about electric pressure. So if you understand water pressure, then you can analogously think of a electric pressure. Okay, given a circuit having a constant resistance, the current through the circuit varies in direct proportion to the voltage across the circuit. So remember, V equals IR. So fixed current, okay, so the voltage and the fixed resistor, so you have a changing voltage and you also change the current. Okay, so directly proportional to the voltage. Now let's talk about ohmmeters. Actually, ohmmeters are simply the presence of current and voltage. Okay, so we know from the Ohm's law V equals IR. Okay, now you must always make certain that no voltage exists between points where you intend to connect the meter terminal. So if you want to measure this one, these two points, okay, make sure that there's this is the part of the meter. Actually, this is the meter part. Okay, so if you want to measure this one and this one, okay, this is the galvanometer, or we call it ohmmeter. Okay, so then make sure that there's no voltage difference here. Okay, so how to make it sure? So the circuit must be unenergized, okay, or unenergized. So what do you mean by unenergized? So it's there's no supply, okay, so that you can measure the ohmic value of the node, no, that you are measuring. Now, technicians usually connect an ohmmeter in a circuit with a meter set for the highest resistance range first. Okay, so they will set the range 1K first. There's a greater one, which is 10K, 100K. They will set first here. And then if the deflection is somewhere here, and they will go smaller, then getting smaller to make the resolution better, okay? But obviously, but if the deflection is here from 100K, so you cannot go down because the next is 10K, so 10K is somewhere here. Let's say this is 10K, and then the deflection is here. So this is the range for 10K, so it's not part of the range, so it is within 0 to 100K, so, or 10K to 100K. So this deflection can only be measured in times 100K. So that's why we need to start from the highest resistance range. Okay, so I will show it to you later. No? Okay, now let's talk about multimeters, or sometimes we call multi-tester. So the one you're seeing in this slide is the analog. You know why analog? Because you have a deflection compass. Okay, so 3-in-1, so ammeter, voltmeter, and ohmmeter. Okay, so this is the two decades ago, no, the multimeters. Now 3-in-1, no.